managed to go from that position where you were worried that he didn't have quite enough to a pawn up endgame?
It's a pawn up endgame, but it's...
This looks like a draw.
It's a very easy draw for the most part.
Yeah, Nakamura does look quite confident. Right,
just a lot of checks and then just keep hitting that g3 pawn.
And the problem is we can't continue to advance the pawn with rook a8 and a7 because then it'll be an easy book draw.
Definitely Naka looks very comfortable.
He does. But nonetheless, Wesley's going to try. And
how do you try here?
I don't know.
Now that you're king's cut off,
I have to play rook a8. And I've got to bring my king all the way over to the beat.
But this is a well-known endgame.
Ooh, g5. That really opens things up. Okay, let's flip back.
Wesley's going to bring the king to a7.
Yes, that's the idea. We want to try to bring the king to a7. And then there's that famous defense where the rook switches over to the side.
Right, but in this case, after king a7, he's definitely going targeting the g-pawn. King a7, rook g1 rook b3 is a superior choice.
Because white needs to try this rook b8 and rook b7 check idea.
So at this point, you're going to sacrifice the rook for the pawn and try to...
No question about it. King h6 looks box so that you can bring your rook, and he has played it, and... I'm expecting something like rook g8. Now king b7. Check. And it's time to take that. Whoa, then he's cut off.
No, this is winning. This is winning.
Well, now you have rook b8. Yeah. Wait. Oh, okay.
Well, no, this should be...
What's the times? What's the times, guys?
17 seconds for Wesley, 10 seconds for Nakamura.
And Wesley trying to squeeze.
And then position. King, he has king b8.
King b8, that's the winner. That's the winner. Yep. And it's a queen. Yep. You just, no, don't, yes.
Oh, and he did.
I was going to say, don't play a8 and press the clock.
He put the queen on the board.
Geez. Big win for Wesley.
That was a heart attack moment, though. I really thought he was going to join the club.
That's g5 is a horrendous move.
If I just play g6, when you do this plan of bringing the king in, I want to play king f5 and king g4. And one thing that's beneficial of keeping the g-pawns is there's no check on the g-file for when you play rook a8, rook g8. So
absolutely.
Is that just a massive basic blunder by Nakamura? Because it seemed, I was calling it as a draw. I just want to make sure that I feel like this, I don't know how to progress as white. I'm going to play king f5, king g4.
I agree. Okay. I think g6 was much, much simpler. G5 really gave white
It seems very concrete. I play king f5 and you're going to have to give up this pawn sooner or later. The black king is far superior to the white king. So that was just a bit of a blooper that I was researching.
Basic blunder, all right.
Very, very good.